I'll start by asking you, what was the reaction like after you scored that spectacular day?
I guess just an ordinary reaction, I would say. It was kind of a weird situation because the call had to get reviewed. And then, honestly, for me, it was just a pleasant surprise that it got called a goal because I wasn't expecting it to be called a goal. When I got back to the bench before the review was happening, our equipment manager, Kyler, was explaining the rule. He's like, it should be a goal because of the rule. And so when I skated up to the referee circle, I saw that they counted it, and it was, yeah, pleasant surprise.
Did you have a firm enough grasp on the rule that you were like, all right, this might be a goal, even though the net's off the netting a little bit there?
Honestly, I wasn't expecting it the whole time until it was called a goal. Just the fact that it, I don't think it was called a goal on the ice, so it obviously takes a lot to reverse a call, but I was just happy to get the first one, and then we just kept rolling after that.
Would you say that's one of the best goals you've ever scored?
I guess so, but it's funny because it was just kind of a last-ditch effort to get a shot on goal after getting tripped, but it was special to do it at Pack the Gut, and with the fans cheering, it was a special moment.
How has this team been able to continue its success despite so many lineup changes during the streak?
Yeah, I think that's been honestly a really – there have been a bunch of special moments this season because of that. We've had to rally together with so many different lineup changes due to Olympics and COVID and all that stuff. And I think just knowing how we play, like we have a style of play that we've really come to and stuck to this whole time. And no matter who's on the ice, no matter who's behind the bench, we find a way to stick to it. And that's what's gotten us success thus far.
This stretch that you guys have been on, mm-hmm. How much more special would it be to get a win this season against the top team in Hockey East?
Oh, it'd be huge. I mean, it's the ultimate test, right? It's all we want to be that team that wins Hockey East, and to do that, we have to go through the best. And so I think we're very excited for this challenge, and especially that Northeastern's number one in the country right now. We already respected them before, and we respect them even more now. So To have a good showing against them is going to really put us on the map, so we're taking it as a big opportunity.
How is Coach Gettin's style different from Coach
Gettin? It's honestly, they're preaching the same things, really. We know how to play, and that's, you know, we know how to play, and it's basically, you know, same concepts, just coming from a different voice. And obviously, Coach Alex brings a different style than Coach Jim, but I mean, like I said, it's just everyone stepped up a little bit more in the absence of people that are not there. And I think, you know, that's what's so special about this team, that anybody who's present is able to get the job done.
Coach Fuller said that he doesn't think he's ever had to coach a game alone at the D1 level. Was it weird from a player's perspective only really having that one voice behind the bench?
I don't know if it was weird, but I mean, Coach Alex really handled it really well. I mean, he was at certain points calling five different people instead of three for the forwards, but I mean, yeah, it was definitely different, but I think, like I said, we just trusted each other and were able to get through it.
This group seems very in sync. Do you think it's one of the stronger groups that you've been a part of?
I would say it's the strongest group I've been a part of, for sure, without question. And I think we have such a good off-ice culture, and I think that's really showing through on the ice. So I think we're the most talented group on the ice and best culture off the ice. So put that together, and it's a good recipe.
What did you learn from the two-game series against Northeastern earlier this season?
Yeah, so in that series, we were down a bunch of people for Olympic qualifiers, and I think, you know, we still lost those two games, but I think 5 out of 6 periods, we had a pretty good showing. And I think being able to do that against the number one team in the country right now, it was a confidence booster for us. Even though we didn't get the result, I think that was actually a turning point in our season. So I think now that we have some of our pieces back, we're even more confident that we can produce more offensively and hopefully continue to play well defensively.
Speaking on that offensive production, mm-hmm. what are, you know, How did it feel kind of watching Mullen absolutely go insane against Holocaust?
Yeah, I mean, she's just so gifted offensively and defensively. You know, she's really found her game this year, and it's amazing to watch. Those are things that can't really be taught. She just has that instinct. She knows where to be, and it's really paying off for her, and it's awesome to watch.
At this stage, mm-hmm. you know, obviously, this next matchup is probably holds the most weight of anything.
Yeah.
Did the win against a then-ranked UConn team mean more than beating BC?
I think it depends who you ask. I'd say for the older crew, beating BC was huge just because of the history, how we hadn't beaten them in God knows how long. But I think in terms of this group specifically and how strong of a team UConn is this year, I think that meant a whole lot. And it was the start of what has now become a 5-game winning streak. So, yeah, I mean, we're gonna have to continue to play well against those top teams. So, yeah. Thank you.